methods of transmission of plant viruses. So now we will see what are all the different methods which are involved in transmission of plant viruses, so that we can manage the plant viruses betterly. So how the plant viruses which are transmitting from uninfected plant to infected plant will be very, very important, so that based on their transmission modes, we can better manage the plant viral disease by means of different management practices. So my name is NH Shankar Reddy, and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So why knowledge of plant virus transmission is important? Because as a virologist, if you are a virologist, so having knowledge on plant virus transmission is important, because then only we can recognize the disease or the cause of disease if transmitted from infected plants to healthy plants. Let us consider, so if a particular area which is infected by some virus, let us consider if it is infected by tobacco mosaic virus, so how it is transmitted from one area to another area, whether it is transmitting by vector or whether it is transmitting by sap or whether it is transmitting by means of any other, so having a knowledge on will be very, very important to recognize that particular virus and how it is transmitted, or what is the transmission agent which is involved in the particular transmission of plant virus, so that we can manage the plant viral diseases efficiently. So then the second one is, how the virus is spread from field will helps to control how, let us consider if it is transmitting by means of vector, if we control the vector, the viral disease can be controlled. If the viral disease is transmitting through by means of seeds, if we avoid the infected seeds or the planting of infected seeds, the particular viral disease can be can be prevented, like this. So so having the knowledge of virus transmission will also help to spread the viral diseases from one area to the uninfected field to from infected field to uninfected field. So establishing the biological relationship of interaction between the virus vector, so what is the virus vector relationship is involved in the transmission of plant viral diseases, can also be established by having the knowledge on virus transmission. So moreover, mechanical transmission is very, very important. So among the different methods of transmission, so mechanical transmission is very, very important in a laboratory by performing the study of plant viruses, because how the viruses are transmitted from from area to area, from infected plant to uninfected plant. So this mechanical transmission will be very, very important. Also serves as a model to perform the experiments in lab, so that we can at least have the basic knowledge on transmission of plant viruses. The types of plant virus transmission. In plant virus transmission, there are two types of transmission, that is horizontal transmission and vertical transmission. So horizontal transmission by means of vectors are the implements that are used by the humans. So and other direct and external contaminations also can be comes under horizontal transmission. Coming to vertical transmission, when the plant gets it from the parent plant, let us consider if the parent plant is get infected, the propagating material that are used from the parent plant will also get infected, so that the infected plants will can have a greater chance of transmission of plant viral disease. Let me tell you an example. If the parent plant get infected with some particular viral diseases, if the same infected mother plants are the propagated materials that we are collecting from that infected mother plant, so that the transmission of plant viral disease will happen, because we had collected the propagating materials from the infected sources, so that the disease can definitely transmit. So this type of transmission is considered as vertical transmission. So either through asexual propagatings like cuttings and the sexual propagatings via infected seeds also comes under the vertical transmission. Here one more thing that I would like to tell you, that is a vector, so that comes under horizontal transmission. Vector in the sense any agent which acts in transmitting a plant viral disease considered as a vector. Vector in the sense any living agent or biological agent which is involved in transmission of plant virus. Let us consider if an insect is transmitting from viral disease from one area to another area, the insect is considered as a vector, because it is a biological agent which is transmitting the plant viral disease from area to another area, that is considered as a vector. So definition and all those things that we will see in further slides. So now we will see the methods of transmission. So in the transmission of plant viral disease, what are all the different methods are involved, or what are all the different methods are there in transmitting of plant viral disease? Now we will see one by one. So here, these methods of transmission is mainly divided into two. That is, the first one is non-insect transmission, insect transmission. Why it is split into two? Because non-insect transmission, what are all the material that comes under non-insect type or the insect type? So because most of the plant viral disease which are transmitted by insects alone, so the remaining non-insect type of transmission may be 5% or 10% that comes under the non-insect type. That's why we divided into two different areas. So now we will see one by one. The first one is non-insect transmission. The non-insect transmission includes sap inoculation or mechanical transmission, the first one. Second one is by means of seeds. The third one by means of fungi. The fourth one by means of vegetative or graft transmission, and the nematodes, dodder. These are the different types of non-insect transmissions which are involved in the transmission of plant viruses. And the second one is insect transmission. Insects, in the sense, were different types of insects that may be aphids or leafhoppers, that may be mealybugs, or some other types of insects which are involved in the transmission of plant virus. That is, comes under insect transmission. So now we will start with the non-insect type. That is, first one is sap inoculation. So the first one is sap transmission or mechanical transmission. This, in the sense, it is most widely used by, which is used to comprise the mechanical inoculation of sap to a range of host plants. So this technique is mostly employed, or this technique mostly used in a laboratory for bioassays or detecting or identification of different types of plant viruses. That's why I told you earlier, it is a model, the transmission method, so that we can understand, that we can at least have the basic idea how the plant viruses which are transmitted from area to area, or from infected plants to uninfected plants. So here in the sap transmission, what are all the different types of methods which are involved in the transmission of sap transmission, in the sense, leaf rub method. So and the first one we can see here, this is leaf rub method, how we can see here. So if we rub infected plant with this is infected one, this is non-infected. If we rub with infected plants to non-infected, the virus can transmitted from infected to non-infected. The second one is cotton scab, then pinprick method, and then micro injection method, in the sense. So cotton swab, if you take a cotton, if you have the sap from the infected plants, the cotton was dipped into that sap, and then if we rub onto the uninfected plants, the virus get transmitted. And then pinprick method, hope this method we had seen in we will see in detail in the later slides. Pinprick, in the sense, if you take that infected plant pots, or maybe if you take that maybe fruits are the different types of materials that can be inoculated, this is the one type of method. A pinprick is a type of method of inoculation of plant viruses. So regarding this, that we will see in the laboratory techniques, so that I will definitely take a further course. So in that we will see in detail, because if we explain here, that will go very big. So then there's the micro injection, so by means of injections or something like that. So here we will see, this is the disease plant. This is a healthy plants. How the virus, which is transmitted from diseased plants to healthy plants. Now we will see the sap transmission. So I'm going to give the procedure. For giving the sap transmission procedure will be very, very important. So at least you guys can have an idea on how, laboratory, how the sap transmission method can be employed in or performed in laboratory techniques. Here you can remember this slide. So this is the diseased one, this is healthy one. Here, the first one, we are picking some leaves here. We can see here, we are picking some diseased leaves. Yes, so remember that. Now we will go to next slide. So how sap transmission, how the methods of sap transmission or inoculation will going on, now we will see. So what are all the requirements for this performing the experiment of sap transmission in laboratory? So we need young symptomatic leaves. So symptom that I told shown you earlier. So now we had picked some infected leaves or symptomatic leaves from the infected plant. Then test plants. So now where we are going to inoculate, so that we need some test plants, in the sense, healthy plants. Okay, then carborundum powder or sea light powder. Carborundum powder or sea light powder. See, this carborundum powder is chemically known as silicon carbide. Very, very important. Silicon carbide. carborundum powder is chemically known as silicon carbide. So this type of question only can ask in a national eligibility test. So carborundum powder, sealate powder, pistol and mortar, phosphate buffer, cotton pads and muslin cloth. These are the different requirements to perform this sap transmission experiment in laboratory. Now we will see the procedure of sap inoculation or sap transmission on cucumber mosaic virus. Now we are seeing on cucumber mosaic virus, maybe you can also take tobacco mosaic virus also, because the tobacco mosaic viruses and the cucumber mosaic viruses both are traps transmission viruses, where the virus can transmit from one area to another area by means of sap only or mechanical transmission only. Now we will see what are all the steps that involved in the sap transmission. The first one is, I told you, symptomatic leaves that we had collected from the diseased plants or infected plants in the laboratory. What we are doing, this infected leaves are what we are collected, collected infected leaves can be washed properly and blotter dry by means of blotter paper. So the infected leaves had been collected and the leaves were washed under washed in water, and it was lightly dried by means of blotter paper or tissue paper. So weight can be recorded. So how much amount of leaves that we are taking, so weight of the leaves can be recorded. So phosphate buffer, second step is, the first step we are collecting the leaves and we are washing the leaves under running water, and then we are drying it. And the second one is phosphate buffer is of 0.1 mm. The pH should be 7.4. so the phosphate the collected buffer or the buffer that we are using in this experiment is phosphate buffer, that is 0.1 mm and 7.4 pH, is taken to the equal volume and weight and volume length, and the weight of the leaves, how much amount of leaves that we had collected, and the record has been recorded already. So the same amount of phosphate buffer is also used here. So equal volume of taking the equal amount of leaves as well as the equal amount of phosphate buffer here. So the leaves are now grounded and sterilized by using pistol and mortar. So here, by we are taking the sterilized pistol and mortar for grinding these leaves. So by using pistol and mortar we are grinded these leaves, use liquid nitrogen. So we are using the liquid nitrogen for particularly hard and fibrous tissue to grind it clearly, that we are using liquid nitrogen here. So in case of phosphate buffer is mixed after proper grinding. So here the phosphate buffer is mixed, sometimes maybe mixed after grinding also, or we can also mix before grinding also. So after grinding the whole leaf pulp, so after grinding what will happen, we will get some liquid materials, or what we call that liquid material is sap or pulp, leaf pulp or sap material, which we can press it through double layered muslin cloth. So after grinding, so we put this into a muslin cloth and get filtered to get the standard extract of leaves. So after, what will happen if we take it, that extract, the liquid material we will get from the infected infected leaves, that infected liquid leaf material is called a sap or pulp, which we had collected through layering of muslin cloth that get filtered. Now on the leaves of the test plant, in the sense, already told you, test plant in the sense uninfected plants or healthy plants. So now what we are doing, now we had sap, so by using carborundum powder or sealite powder, I told you already, carborundum powder chemically known as silicon carbide, it's very very important. So this silicon carbide or sealed powder is, which is we usually use to dust on the healthy plants. Why we are dusting on the healthy plant? To make injuries, because we are performing experiment here. So if we dust it on the healthy plants, it will make little bit injuries that will be helpful for inoculation. So if we inoculate on non-injured leaves or uninjured leaves, that won't be we won't get the desired results. So now we are using carborundum powder for making injuries on leaves. So after that, what will happen, a cotton pad or cotton is, which is soaked on the extract that we already had earlier. So now earlier we had some sap material from the infected sources. So the cotton scab is soaked into that, and then which is rubbed on the healthy leaves. So after soaking onto the sap material, the cotton is taken out and which is rubbed onto the healthy plants or the test plants. After that, what will happen? So after inoculating onto the healthy plants, So we let it let the plant which is inoculated into the laboratory conditions or a glasshouse conditions for the observations. So we usually tobacco mosaic viruses or cucumber mosaic virus had been used for this experiment. I am coming once again. We are collecting the first of all we are collecting the infected plant leaves. The infected plant leaves can be weighed. After that, what we are doing, we are using buffer solution or some liquid nitrogen for grinding. After that, buffer solution can be added, equal amount of volumes of buffer solution can be added, so that after grinding through sterilized pistol and mortar, we are having some solution or liquid material. So this liquid material can be if we want to store this liquid material, we can store at -4 degrees centigrade for further uses. So now we are taking some test plants, that is healthy plants. So by using carborundum powder, we are making some wounds on it, and after that a cotton which is soaked onto the liquid materials or sap material that we had extracted earlier, or extended extract. After that, what we are doing, we are taking that cotton and rubbing on the injured leaves by using carborundum powder, that is the test plants that we are rubbing onto the test plants, and then we are inoculating into the greenhouse condition for for observations. After 5 or 10 days, we can observe that tobacco mosaic virus symptoms on the healthy plants. So example, tobacco mosaic virus, we can use this purpose. It is a very very important. Let's say now try to have a small idea on it. That's why I placed this procedure. The second one is by means of grafting or donor transmission. So by means of grafting or donor is also act as a transmission of plant viruses. Best example here, Chinnapudi amaranth cooler and grapevine. By approach, graft is observed in the successful experiment. So in performing the lab, so grafting of a grapevine and Chinnapudi amaranth cooler, which is which is act as an indicator plant for plant viruses. The common name is goosefoot. The common name is goosefoot. Chinnapodium amaranth cooler. So by using Chinnapodium amaranth cooler and grapevine grafts, the experiment has been performed in a laboratory. Thus, in actually in a plant virology, special techniques of grafting has been developed for this identification or doing in laboratory conditions. So actually, this type of special grafting techniques that we are using in plant virology, that was not usually used in the plant propagation techniques. So what are all the propagation techniques, like wedge grafting or top side cleft grafting, approach grafting, budding or leaf patch grafting? These are all the different types of special techniques of grafting. Different types of techniques are which are used in the plant virology laboratory for experimenting or observing this. So through grafting, tomato yellow mosaic virus, tomato yellow leaf curl virus, tomato yellow leaf curl virus can be transmitted through by means of grafting material. The next one is dodder. So dodder transmission is a very effective method for the transmission of plant viruses in nature. And also in greenhouses, but it is a very very important methods of transmission of plant viruses. So different types of plant viruses has been reported that are transmitted by means of dodder. So now we'll see this dodder species of dodder, Cuscuta species. So dodder in the sense Cuscuta. So this mainly belong to the family Convolvulaceae, involved in the transmission of plant viral disease. So those viruses who can't able to transmit mechanical or vector transmission, that they can transmit it by means of dodder. So here we can observe those viruses which can't able to transmit by means of mechanical or vector, that they can select, or by means of dodder that they can transmit from one infected plant to uninfected plants. So we all will know very well about that dodder can absorb. Not only dodder, all phanerogamic plant parasite can absorb nutrients by means of host ori. It's an important question for NET also. They will ask like this, dodder, or they will ask one of the plant phanerogamic parasite, that may be Cuscuta or Loranthus, Warabankia or Striga. They will ask any one type of plant phanerogamic plant parasite, and they will ask like this, Striga absorb nutrients through, or some other plant phanerogamic parasite absorb nutrients through. Whatever it is, all phanerogamic plant parasite absorb nutrients through Haustoria only. So, and they transmit, this dodder transmitted viruses, like species like Cuscuta campestris or Cuscuta refluxa and Cuscuta subinucleosa are the different types of Cuscuta species which are commonly used in the transmission of plant viruses, and Plytoplasma also. Now, seed and pollen transmission. So about 20% of the known plant viruses has been reported to be transmitted by means of seed through infected host plants, which in the sense nearly 20% of the plant viral disease has been reported or known for the transmission of transmission through seeds or the pollen materials. So far 100 viruses have been reported, nearly 100 viruses has been reported that are transmitted by means of seed. That means of seed. Example, barley stripe mosaic viruses in barley, tobacco ring spot virus, and cherry leaf roll viruses in Chinapodium amaranthophora. These are the different types of viruses which are transmitted by means of seed. And one important virus that is transmitted by Prunus necrotic ring spot, very, very important. Prunus necrotic ring spot virus, which is transmitted by pollen. This type of questions only will ask in NET. So Prunus necrotic ring spot virus, which is transmitted by pollen. This is the infected sources or the seed materials that consist of virus. So that if you plant this type of material, definitely you will get the virus infection. So the pollen also can be involved in transmission of plant viral diseases. So now we'll see what are all the different types of factors that affect on seed transmission. So during seed transmission and the pollen transmission, not in pollen, but in the seed transmission, there are few of the factors that can affect that seed transmission of plant viruses efficiently. So these factors can affect the virulence of the plant viral disease, or maybe reduce that, maybe sometimes it can increase the virulence of the plant viral disease that can lead to huge losses as well as the reduction of losses. Now we will see what are all the factors that involved in seed transmission. So the first one is virus and virus strain. Second one is host plants. Third one is infection time. Fourth one is mode of pollination and pollen transmission. Fifth one is location of seed on plant, age of seed and environment. So these are all the different factors that can affect the seed transmission. Insect vector transmission. It is a very, very important because most of the plant viral disease, nearly 95%, maybe more than that, maybe 90 to 95% of the plant viral disease mainly transmitted by means of vectors, or especially insects. So insects are majorly involved in the transmission of plant viral disease because plant viruses can't able to move on air or by means of some other measures. So a vector can be needed, or a vector that, let me give you a definition of vector. As I told you earlier, so vector is an agent or biological agent which introduces the virus into plant tissues. It is called as vector. I will give you one more definition. Vector is an agent or biological agent which transmits a plant virus from one area to another area, or from infected plants to uninfected plants is considered as a vector. That vector may be insect or some other consider them also. We can seeds, these are also considered as vectors, but mainly in the sense or definition or in the sense of vector that can mostly devoted to insects only, because as I told you, most of the plant viruses are transmitted by vectors only. Sorry, that is insects only. So now we will put some light on historical background of this insect transmission. So Japanese were the first to experimentally prove that insects are mainly involved in the transmission of plant viral disease in the era of 1895 to 1901. And some other examples as are giving here: rice dwarf virus, which is transmitted by leaf hopper, Nephrotetics syncytiosus, and some other species also will be there. And beet caulitop virus, which is transmitted by leaf hopper, Cercluferus tenacellus, and then cucumber mosaic virus, Aphis gossopi. So these are all the some of the examples as begin. Now we will see different types of vectors. So what are all the insects which are involved in? Now we will see one by one. So as I told you that insects are the most important group of transmission of plant viruses. Now we will see how important that insects are involved in transmitting of plant viral diseases. So more than 400 species of insects has been reported that can transmit plant viruses. Nearly 400 species of plant virus, sorry, insects are involved in transmitting plant viral disease. 94% of these belong to the phylum Arthropod. 94% of these belong to Arthropod. Among that, 90% are insect. Among that, 90% are insects. So 70% of the insect that belong to the Homoptera, which is Aphididae, are the most important group in transmitting of plant viral diseases. So let me tell you one thing. So which group of insects are mostly involved in transmitting of plant viral diseases? That is Homoptera. This type of questions only can ask in NET. So make sure that 75%, sorry, 70% of the insects that belonging to the Homoptera, which can transmit plant viral disease, sorry, which can transmit plant viral disease. So some examples are like leaf hopper, plant hopper, white fly, beetles, mealybugs, thrips, mites or fungi, nematodes, which are different vectors are involved in transmitting of plant viral diseases. So among that, aphids are very, very, very important. Nearly 60 to 70% of the plant viral diseases which are transmitted by aphids only. So this is just an outlook of how the plant virus is, regarding that we had seen some definition, acquisition feeding period, acquisition IISS period in earlier presentations, so that you will understand this. So how the plant virus, so after sucking into plant cells, so the virus which is present here that can acquired and can goes to foregut, and some of the type of transmission like circulatory type that can circulate all over the body and then go to hindgut, hemolymph, and sometimes while this infected insect vector which is coming to feed on uninfected leaf, what will happen? The virus which is present in the infected insect that can inject into the uninfected plant, so that a virus transmission will happens. So this is just like a outlook. Now we will see what are all the different types of vectors which are involved in transmission of plant viral disease. The first one is aphids. As I told you, aphids are the very, very important vectors in transmitting of plant viral diseases. Nearly 60 to 70% of the plant viral diseases are transmitted by aphids only. It's a very important group of in transmitting plant viral viruses. So aphids are parthenogenic. Without fertilization, they can produce their progeny. So here some of the aphids are polyphagous. Best example, Mysis persicae. This is an example of polyphagous. So aphids are the important group in transmitting plant viral diseases. These are the pictures of aphids. We can see here pictures of aphids. So the second important one is leafhopper. So leafhopper belonging to the group Homoptera. As you seen earlier, Homoptera, nearly 70% of insect that comes under Homoptera, the very, very important groups in transmitting of in transmitting plant viral diseases. So this leafhopper consists of sucking mouth parts, as like of aphids, because aphids also consist of sucking type of mouth parts. So this can cause different types of diseases, causes yellowing and leaf reflowing. So this leafhoppers are stylet borne, circulative, propagative. Hope you guys will know what is the meaning of propagative, circulative, because we had seen in before presentation only, or before class only. So beet curly top, beet curly top is also transmitted by leafhopper, which is a circulative or non-propagative type. Hope you guys will know about what is circulative, propagative. If you don't know, you can see the earlier presentation so that you will have an idea on this. So the next one is the leafhopper or plant hoppers, which are also act as a vectors in transmitting plant viral diseases. So this leafhoppers are comes under group, or this leafhoppers are plants, plant hopper comes under order Homoptera. So examples are given here: the rice dwarf virus or yellow dwarf virus, which is transmitted by Nephrotitis syncytiosis, which is a leafhopper or plant hopper. So rice tungro virus is transmitted by Nephrotitis impicticeps. So rice dwarf virus is transmitted by Nephrotitis impicticeps, and rice yellow dwarf virus is transmitted by Nephrotitis syncytiosis. And transorial transmission can be observed in rice dwarf virus. Hope you guys will know about what is transorial transmission, that I had explained in earlier PowerPoint presentation. So then plant hopper, so mice mosaic virus, which is transmitted by plant hopper, and the tree hopper, tomato pseudo curly top virus, which is transmitted by plant hopper. Scientific names has been given here. This is a plant hopper. Then white fly, that comes under the order Hemiptera. So white fly, white fly species that is involved in transmitting plant viral disease is Bimisia tabaci. So this is the main species of white fly that is transmitting plant viral diseases. So circulative or semi-persistent to persistent type of transmission can be observed in white fly transmission transmitting vectors. So this mainly consists of sucking and stylet, sucking type of mouth parts can be observed in white flies. So examples is cotton curly, so leaf curl virus, and then tobacco leaf curl virus, tomato leaf curl virus, and mung bean mosaic virus. These are the different types of virus which is transmitted by white flies. Then thrips. So thrips that comes under order Thysanura, which they feeds on subepidermal cells or hosts. And then example of viruses that is transmitted by thrips are Tospovirus, Ehlers virus, that is alfalfa mosaic virus, Cormo virus, that is coronation model virus, or Sobemo virus, bean southern mosaic virus, or Maclomovirus, maize chlorotic model virus. These are all the different types of genera that that can be transmitted by thrips. So thrips tabaci are, you know, these are the important species that can involved in the transmission of different plant viral diseases, and some other like Occidentalis and Fusca and Strudelesi, the species also involved in transmitting plant viral disease. This is a picture of thrip. And then mealybug, that belongs to Hemiptera. The main species are involved in transmitting plant viral diseases. The species of mealybug is Planococcus species, which are involved in transmitting plant viral diseases. They mainly feeds on phloem. Here both nymphs and juveniles are most active in transmitting viral diseases. Here important one is both the nymphs and juveniles are very active in transmitting plant viral disease. Best example is Coco solen shoot or Coco mottle virus, which are transmitted by mealybug. Very very important. Banana streak virus also transmitted by mealybug, but the important one is Coco solen shoot, which is transmitted by mealybug. This is mealybug. The next one is insect vector is beetle, that comes under order Coleoptera. So it consists of chewing and biting type of mouth parts. Mainly circulatory type of insect transmission can be involved in here. Here the salivary glands of beetles are not well developed. The main viral diseases that are transmitted by beetles is Kaupi mosaic virus, Kaupi chlorotic model, radish mosaic, Turnipello mosaic, squash mosaic. These are all are transmitted by beetles only. So cucumber beetle, which is involved in the transmission of Diabrotica antisipunctata. This is a cucumber beetle which causes diseases. Beetle which is causes plant viral disease transmission. Then mites. So mites consist of sucking type of mouth parts. The main two types of mites are involved in aerophid mouth, spider mouth. This is aerophid mite. The first one is aerophid mite. The second one is spider mite. So here the virus is retained after molting, and there is no transmission through eggs can be reported so far. So here the virus can only transmitted during molting only, and through eggs there is no virus can be transmitted of aerophid. So during aerophid mite developing stages, only molting stage can be transmitted the virus, but not eggs. So this mite transmits reported virus Y in a non-persistent manner. So aerophid mites can also spread by means of wind because of lightweight. So Asaria kajani, Asaria tulipae are the main species of mites that is involved in the transmission of plant viral diseases. So Asaria tulipae, wheat streak mosaic virus, and then Pygon pea sterility mosaic virus, which is transmitted by the mite Asaria kajani. So last one is nematode and fungal transmission. So some of the species of nematodes and fungi is also involved in the transmission of plant viral diseases. So first of all, we will see nematodes. Two genera of nematodes which is involved in the transmission of plant viral disease, that is Nepo viruses and Neto viruses. Nepo means nematode transmitted polyhedral viruses, nematode transmitted tubular viruses. These are the two species of viruses which are involved in transmitting of plant viral disease. So some of the nematode vectors like Ziphinima, Longidorus, Trichodorus and Paratrichodorus are the different types of species, genuses which are involved in the transmission of plant viral. This is a nematode species. There are mainly two species are involved, that is Nepo viruses, nematode transmitted polyhedral viruses, and the second one is Neto viruses, nematode transmitted tubular viruses. These are two species of nematodes which are involved, genera of nematodes which are involved in transmitting of plant viral diseases, and the species included in Ziphinima, Longidorus, Trichodorus and Paratrichodorus. Some of the examples has been given. Grape fan leaf virus is transmitted by Ziphinima index, Arabis mosaic viruses and tobacco ring spot viruses, which are also transmitted by nematodes. And then fungi. So there's some species of fungi like Ophidium, Polymyxa, Spongospora, are the different types of fungi which are act as a vector in transmitting of plant viral diseases. So nematodes had, we had seen. So some of the species of fungi, that is Wolfidium, Polymyxa, Spongospora, is also involved in the transmission of plant viral diseases. Now we'll see here tobacco necrosis virus, which is transmitted by Wolfidium brassica, which is a fungi. Cucumber necrosis virus is transmitted by Wolfidium radicale, and Lettuce bigwin virus is transmitted by Wolfidium brassicae. Some of the species like Polymyxa graminis, which is transmit wheat mosaic, Polymyxa beetae, which transmit beet necrotic yellowvine virus, and Spongospora subterranea, important one, which is transmitted which transmits potato mop top virus. And important one, it is potato mop top virus is transmitted by fungi, that is Spongospora subterranea. And this is about transmission of plant viruses.